Borthakur IAS Academy, an endeavor of excellence.
Borthakur IAS Academy.
Hello friends, welcome to Borthakur's IAS Academy, Northeast's premier institute for UPSC and APSC preparations. I hope you all are doing well, safe at your respective homes and taking good care of yourself, your family and friends. Today, I'm extremely happy and also very excited to share with you all the first segment of Current Affairs 365. First of all, let me introduce you all to the concept. Okay, what are we planning in this particular segment? How we will be proceeding here, right? So first, as the name itself suggests, Current Affairs 365. Bosorar protekto dinore 365 days or jikhini news ami paun, jikhini important topics hoy for jikunu exam, right? Be it UPSC, APSC or other government exams. As I have repeatedly mentioned, moi bare bare etu kotha koisu je jetia ami current affairs cover koru, tetia okol eta particular exam mok focus kori ami current affairs cover nokoru. Jikunu aspirant e nohok kyo. Teoluke belek belek exams or karne prepare kore, aru jodiu ba teoluk eta exam ot focus hoy thake. Then also, it is preferable if they, attempt other exams. Because hetu telukor karne eta mock hisabeo hoy, aru teoluke nijor bahut eta phal experience gather kore from the other exams, right? Mock tests bilak hekarne dia hoy, aru jikunu belek government exam. There is no harm in appearing in those exams, right? So hekarne, a current affairs 365 is going to be your one-stop solution for all the important news and updates. Protect to source or para. Jikini important hoy, jikita important sources as for examination point, from examinations point of view, like the Assam Tribune, one of the most important daily newspaper for Assam related news, that will be covered. Then the Indian Express, national importance news cover hobo, Business Standard, Yarpara news cover hobo, okay, and also from PIB. Then your important ministerial news jibur thake ministries bilake jekhini update diye, right, hekhini ami cover korim. Tar logote important monthly magazines Kurukshetra, Yojna, Down to Earth, ebilak magazines or kotha apnaloke hunise sage, we will also be covering important topics from those news, okay, from those magazines jekhini dorkari updates thake. Obviously it is not possible to cover each and every topic, but we will sort out the most important and probable topics and we will place it in front of you all, right? And then along with that, ami yearbook susam, Assam yearbook, Indian yearbook, tarpara jodi kiba important topics thake, then in due course of time, we will also try to include all these, okay? So stay tuned with us. Don't forget to be a part of our family, right? We want our family to grow as much as possible. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, like and share the videos, and also stay tuned on the social media platforms. Facebook, Instagram, Telegram, we are there on all sorts of platforms, okay? You can be a part of our family. Our family is growing and we want all of you to be a part of it. So, aji, first news to hoise about the 2021 Vidhan Sabha election results. And here, BJP has created history in the state by becoming the only non-Congress government to win consecutive terms. This particular election was important for Assam because here it was a fight to retain power. Aru yat jitu rainbow coalition hoy of the ruling NDA, tar jikhini parties included hoy asile BJP, AGP, Akham Gana Parishad, aru UPPL, that is the United People's Party Liberal. So, ekitai mili pelai, they were competing against the Congress-led Grand Alliance and also the newly formed parties, two newly formed regional parties, which were the Assam Jatiya Parishad and the Raizor Dal. This particular party, the Assam Jatiya Parishad and the Raizor Dal, it emerged out of the Anti-Citizenship Amendment Act protest that swept Assam in the year 2019, December 2019. The second important news is also regarding the 2021 Vidhan Sabha elections of Assam. And here, Okhil Gogoi, he has created history by becoming the first in Assam to win an election from jail. He is the one who has won this election without hitting the campaign trials. And he has won from the Sipsagar constituency. Constituency naam to monot rakhibo. And also, Okhil Gogoi is the leader of Raizor Dal, a party which came into existence after the Ka agitation of December 2019. So here he has defeated his nearest rival Surabhi Rajkumari from BJP by a huge amount of 11,875 votes. Akhil Gogoi is also an RTI activist, we know that, and he, during the time of his stay in jail, he has been reportedly writing several open letters to the people where he have tried to highlight the problems that needs immediate solution, that needs to be addressed immediately. And also another another thing which must have struck the chord of the people is that his 85-year-old mother, she has taken a lot of effort in campaigning, because her son was in the prison and he could not participate in the campaigns. Therefore, his mother, along with a huge number of youth volunteers and the members of Rai Jor Dal, they participated in the campaigns and they tried to woo the voters ahead of the three-phase polls. If you want to know about Akhil Gogoi, then he was a graduate from Cotton College and he has served as the General Secretary of the Cotton College Students Union in the year 95-96. Third important news is regarding COVID impact on the women labor force. This news has been sourced from the Assam Tribune, from the editorial section dated 3rd of May 2021. And it is important because this particular article, not the same, but certain related articles have been repeatedly published in the important newspapers, and that is why we will have to analyze it under the GS paper 2, that is issues related to women, gender, employment, and also issues relating to development of our country. Female labor force participation in India has always been a matter of debate, because India has struggled from the very beginning to provide women with equal opportunities. Akal COVID-19 pandemic buliye nahi, even before pandemic, according to a statistical report of the year 2019, it is seen that the female labor force participation in India was 23.5%, which is significantly less. And pandemic has further deteriorated the situation. Kyo? Karan, the sectors in which women are employed, women work, that has been the hard hit, okay? And most of the women, we know that they contribute to the informal economy because they are the primary caregivers at home. So, hekarne hekhini iman besi consider koran hoy. Hei jekhini women labor hoy, teolukor jitu impact hoy, hetu iman besi consideration hotu na hai. Therefore, for the recovery of our Indian economy after the pandemic period, we will have to include a concerted effort, not just from the government, but also from the society. The citizens will also have to work on it, okay? Because we all know that women can become a very critical part of the economic recovery journey. Therefore, we will have to analyze, we'll have to address this long-standing issues which are hampering the female labor force participation in India. So, a problem would arise kyo hai? First of all, why we have always struggled in providing equal opportunities to women. Most important, most jitu relevant cause hoise, hetu hoise stereotyping the society. Amar jitu societal norms hoy, it is such that women are expected to stay at home and take the responsibility of family. They need to take care of the family and also the children, right? So age to stereotype hoy, this itself is a barrier for women labor force participation. Another important issue hoy, problem hoy, that is the digital divide. Among the internet users in the urban areas of India, we see that only 33% are female users. Okay, 67% are male users. So during the pandemic period last year, jetia gutekhini important or critical service online mode shift hoy goisile, like education, health and finance, hetu khomayot, as the percentage of female internet users were less, because of that only they were further deprived, right? Jikhini access na thakar karne teoluke jikhini huvidha normally males kiniye pai asile ba urban areas or female who had access to internet, they were getting. These rural areas, women of the belonging to the rural areas, they were further deprived of those facilities. Aru yar logote jikhini gender related data thake taru kunu authentic source nai. টু ইউ নো মনিটৰ দ্য প্ৰগ্ৰেছ। চ' সেইকাৰণে এইখিনি যিখিনি ডেটা হয় অফ দ্য জেণ্ডাৰ ৰিলেটেড গেপ ইন এনি পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ ৰিজন, তাৰ যদি কোনো অথেণ্টিক ৰিপৰ্ট নাথাকে দেন ইট ফাৰ্ডাৰ বিকামছ ডিফিকাল্ট টু মনিটৰ দ্য প্ৰচেছ। আগতে কিমানখিনি ওমেন দে ৱেৰ এমপ্লয়ড, হাউ মেনি অফ দেম হেভ লষ্ট দেয়াৰ জব ইন দ্য পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ পিৰিয়ড এণ্ড ফৰ লাইক resumed their work. So ei gute khini calculate koribole jitu data lage that is not authentic and that is not easily available also. So he karone this is another hurdle to monitor the same problem, right? Aru covid-19 or problem jikhini covid-19 pandemic or karone jikhini job loss hoisile, jikhini manu unemployed hobologe hoisile, tar majot tar he population to jodi ami compare koru then compared to the male population 19% of the females their jobs were at risk or they had to lose their job, okay? And by the end of August 2020 amar India scenario to enekua hoisile je women were 9.5% less likely to be employed after the pandemic period is over. So this was the condition in India and also which has been proved by the World Economic Forum's Global Gender Gap Report. এইটো আমি ডিছকাছ কৰিছিলোঁ ইন আৱাৰ লাষ্ট নিউজ, ৰাইট? ৱৰ্ল্ড ইকনমিক ফৰামৰ যিটো গ্ল'বেল জেণ্ডাৰ গেপ ইণ্ডেক্স আছিলে তাত ইণ্ডিয়াৰ পজিশ্যনটো শ্লিপ হৈ গৈছিলে টু দ্য 112th পজিশ্যন এণ্ড দিছ ৱাজ অনলি বিকজ অ'ভাৰ 70 lakh ইণ্ডিয়ান ৱিমেন দে হেভ ড্ৰপড আউট অফ ৱৰ্ক, দে হেড টু লুজ দেয়াৰ ৱৰ্ক বিকজ অফ দ্য পেণ্ডামিক। আৰু এতিয়া দ্য অনলি ৱে টু ব্ৰিজ দিছ গেপ, অনলি ৱে টু মুভ আহেড ইজ টু provide better facilities to the women, okay? Maybe we can bridge the digital divide jitu ami eta divide paiso between the male and the female internet users. We should try to bridge that gap, okay? And then we should also provide flexible working hours to the women, because we all know that each woman, they have to not just work for herself but also have to take care of her family, right? So under that situation jodi ami all the organizations, be all the sectors, be it government or private, if they allow flexible working hours for their women employees, then it becomes easier for them to continue with their jobs, right? And also we can give certain fiscal incentives like lower income tax for women. That can be done. It can further improve the participation of women in our economy, right? And we also need to encourage the growing women entrepreneurs, because by creating jobs they are not only helping themselves, okay, they are not only becoming financially independent but they are also contributing to the Indian economy and society and providing employments to others as well. So these are the few steps that we can take to bridge the gap and to improve the women labor force, condition of women labor force in our country after the COVID period, even after the COVID impact. Next, news at ase regarding the launch of Operation Samudra Setu 2. Second edition to launch korise by the Indian Navy to bring oxygen-filled containers to India during the second wave of COVID-19. Etia bortoman jitu amar situation hoy India because of second wave of COVID-19, it is very dangerous, right? We don't have enough resource of oxygen and also other medical equipments. Hekhinu amar karone bahut dorkari hoi goise etia. And so for shipment of oxygen filled containers and also medical equipments, Indian Navy has launched the Operation Samudra Setu 2. Originally jitu first edition asile Samudra Setu, Operation Samudra Setu, this was launched in May 2020, jitu mai agote discuss korisilu purona analysis, right? It was a part of the national effort to bring back the Indian citizens from overseas. Jetia pandemic or karane travel restrictions ahi goisile hetu period Indian naval ships Jalashwa, Airavat, Shardul and Magar, they participated in this operation and more than 4000 Indian citizens from the neighboring countries, they were successfully brought back to India, right? Aru Indian Navy আগতেও এনেকুৱা অপাৰেশ্যনছত, ইভাকুৱেশ্যন অপাৰেশ্যনছত পাৰ্টিচিপেট কৰিছে, লাইক অপাৰেশ্যন চুকুন ইন 2006 এণ্ড অপাৰেশ্যন ৰাহত ইন 2015. দিছ পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ অপাৰেশ্যন সমুদ্ৰ সেতু, ইট ইজ আ পাৰ্ট অফ দ্য বন্দে ভাৰত মিছন, উইচ ইজ ওৱান অফ দ্য বিগেষ্ট চিভিলিয়ান ইভাকুৱেশ্যন এক্সাৰচাইজ কণ্ডাক্টেড বাই ইণ্ডিয়া। আৰু এই পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ অপাৰেশ্যন সমুদ্ৰ সেতু টু যিটো মিছন হয় এই পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ অপাৰেশ্যনটোত ইণ্ডিয়াৰ পৰা INS কলকাতা, INS তলৱাৰ, INS জলশ্বা এণ্ড INS এৰাৱত এইকেইখন বেলেগ বেলেগ জেগালৈ গৈছে, লাইক দ্য পৰ্টছ অফ বাহৰেইন মানামাত গৈছে, দেন অলছো টু বেংকক কেপিটেল অফ থাইলেণ্ড এণ্ড ছিংগাপুৰ, তাত এনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ মিছনছলৈ গৈছে য'ত তেওঁলোকে য'ত তাৰ পৰা অক্সিজেন ফিল্ড ক্ৰায়োজেনিক কণ্টেইনাৰ্ছ আৰু মেডিকেল ইকুইপমেণ্টছবোৰ লৈ পেলাই আমাৰ নেশ্যনেললৈ আহিব। দিছ অলছো শ্ব'জ দেট উই হেভ আ ষ্ট্ৰং বায়'লেটাৰেল ৰিলেশ্যন বিটুইন দিজ নেশ্যনছ, ৰাইট? Next news is regarding the World Press Freedom Day, which is observed every year on 3rd of May. This year's theme was Information as Public Good. And this day acts as a reminder to the governments of the need to respect their commitment to the press freedom, right? And it is an opportunity to celebrate the fundamental principles of press freedom. It provides an assessment of the state of press freedom throughout the world in all the countries. This also is an opportunity to defend the media from attacks on their independence and pays also acts as a day to pay tribute to the journalists who have lost their lives in the line of duty. Next news to hoise the Global Forest Goals Report 2021. This report is prepared by the Department of Economic and Social Affairs of the United Nations. Aro ebaro report to এইটো মেনশ্যন কৰা হৈছে যে কোভিড নাইনটিন হেজ এগ্ৰিভেটেড দ্য চেলেঞ্জেছ ফেচ বাই কাণ্ট্ৰিজ ইন মেনেজিং দেয়াৰ ফৰেষ্ট। ইট ইজ অলছো কোৱাইট এভিডেণ্ট বিকজ এতিয়া কোভিড নাইনটিন ইজ নট জাষ্ট আ হেল্থ ক্ৰাইচিছ, দিছ ইজ দ্য মেইন ৰিজন ফৰ লছ অফ লাইফছ, লাইভলিহুডছ, এক্সট্ৰিম পভাৰ্টি এমাং চাৰ্টেইন পপুলেশ্যন গ্ৰুপছ, ৰাইট? ইনইকুৱেলিটি বিকজ অফ লছ অফ জব অপৰচুনিটিজ, ফুড ইনচিকিউৰিটি এণ্ড many such reasons, right? aru he karone jetia ei forest dependent population khini effect hoise bahut basic, they have lost their jobs, their incomes have been reduced, right? telukor market aru information or uporat besi access nai, government e jekhini khubidha provide kori ase, jekhini healthcare provide kori ase, hekhini programs teluke bhalke avail koribo paranai, so this has put on a lot of pressure on the existing forest resources, karon knowingly unknowingly they are becoming more dependent on the forest products, right? kintu teneke maintain koribo parane forest kini, so he karone they have it has resulted in the migration of these workers into deeper into the roots to seek food, fuel, shelter and protection from the risks of covid 19 aru he karone proper management of the forest resources has not been done in the last year because of covid 19 Next topic to hoise climate change causing a shift in earth's axis which might also cause a change in the polar motion. So first of all, earth's axis ki hoy, it is the imaginary line along which the earth spins around itself and revolves around the earth. Aru we all know the earth's axial tilt which is about 23.5 degrees, and because of this slight tilt in the earth's axis this is the main reason for seasonal changes, because the sun shines on different latitudes at different angles throughout the year, aru he karone depending on this variation there is change in seasons. Recently at a research study eta publish kara hoisile in the geophysical research letters of the American Geophysical Union, tat teoluke etu point korise je due to the significant melting of glaciers as because of global warming, right, the earth's axis of rotation it has been seen to move a little bit than the usual 1990s or agar jitu shift asile jitu position asile earth's axis or hetu all of change hoa dekha goise because of the rising global temperature which has resulted in melting of glaciers aru ei jitu effect hoy ei jitu change hoy it is not likely to have any impact on our daily life, but it can change the length of the day by a few milliseconds in due course of time. Our polar motion jitu mai koisilu first ata mention korisilu ami janu je the point at which our earth's surface intersect with the axis, these are known as the geographical north and south pole, right? And location of our poles, these are also not fixed. Amar earth or jitu north or south pole hoy tar jekhini location hoy it keeps on changing as the earth axis moves. That is, the poles, they move when the axis moves. And this particular movement is called the polar motion. Agote polar motion mainly cause hoisile because of changes in hydrosphere, atmosphere, oceans or solid earth. But now, after this recent study, climate change is also seen as a reason why there can be a slight change in the polar motion as the earth's axis will shift, right? Jodi polar motion is known as the motion of the poles when axis moves. So obviously, jodi kiba ta beleg external cause or karne axis of movement hoy, axis or shift hoy, then that is also going to have an impact on the polar motion, right? So this was all about this particular study. Next, jikhon slide hoy, tat apnaloke dekhibo paise the magnetic north and south pole, magnetic and geographic north and south pole of our earth, okay? And because of the slight tilt, etio apnaloke dekhise je axis dal eta tilted ase at an angle of around 23.5 degree, and this, because of this earth's axial tilt, mainly the variation in seasons occurs. Next news is about a new species of woody snakes named Xylophis deepaki. Woody snake are mostly harmless, okay, non-venomous, and they are often found while digging soil in farms or under the logs in western Ghat forest. Ebaru eta coconut plantation, Kanyakumari coconut plantation etat a particular jitu snake species hoy etu discover kora hoise, and it has been named in honor of the Indian herpetologist Deepak Virappan. Herpetology ki hoy, it is a branch of zoology which deals with amphibians and reptiles. So this was all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you all again with another session of Current Affairs 365. We will be including much more in the upcoming sessions. So please stay tuned for that. আৰু ইয়াৰ লগতে আৰু এটা মই কথা মেনশ্যন কৰিব খুজিছোঁ, মই আগৰ যিখিনি আমাৰ আসাম ট্ৰিবিউন এনালাইচিছ আছিলে তাতে বহুতে মেনশ্যন কৰিছিলে ৰিগাৰ্ডিং দ্য PDF, অ'কে, প্ৰত্যেক দিনাৰ যিখিনি ইনফৰ্মেশ্যন থাকে, নিউজ থাকে, সেইখিনিৰ PDFটো আমি কেনেকৈ পাম। চ' এতিয়াৰ পৰা যিখিনি কাৰেণ্ট এফেয়াৰ্ছ 365 হয় তাৰ আপোনালোকে উইকলি PDF পাব, আমি প্ৰভাইড কৰিম ইন আৰ ইউটিউব চেনেল ইটছেল্ফ। চ' আজিৰ পৰা যিখিনি ষ্টাৰ্ট হ'ব, মানে থাৰ্ডটো কনচিডাৰ কৰি ল'ম মই। সো থার্ডর পৰা এই মানডে পৰা স্যাটারডে লৈকে যিখিনি থাকিব সেইখিনি আমি এটা পার্টিকুলাৰ উইকত ৰাখিম, এণ্ড দেন আকৌ নেক্সট উইকত আমি তেনেকৈ আপোনালোকক PDFs খিনি প্ৰভাইড কৰিম। সো ইউ উইল ফ্ৰম নাও ইউ উইল নট জাস্ট গেট দ্য ভিডিওজ বাট অলসো এণ্ড অলসো দ্য PDFs, এণ্ড উই উইল কভাৰ অল দ্য ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট sources, not just Assam Tribune but all the other sources. I hope that this will be a one-stop solution for your problem of current affairs, okay? You don't have to go to any other source after this. So with that, I'll see you all again tomorrow. Take care, bye-bye.
Borthakur IS Academy Prastuti Aru Adhyayanor Nirbhorjoggyo Thikona Borthakur IS Academy